Welcome back. In this presentation, we are going to study about insulin structure. Before going to insulin structure proper, let us know some of the great Nobel scientists who discovered insulin. A Canadian doctor, physician Bunting, and medical student Charles Best, they are able to extract insulin from the dog pancreas. This is during 1921. And later, during 1922, along with Canadian chemist Colley and Scottish physiologist MacLeod. So all these four people are able to extract or purify insulin and able to treat a boy suffering from severe diabetes mellitus. For this Nobel work, they were awarded Nobel Prize in 1923. This is about brief discovery of insulin. And later on, during 1954, Frederick Sanger, he studied the amino acid sequence of insulin. You know, this insulin is a peptide hormone. That means it is made up of amino acid. During 1954, Frederick Sanger able to identify the amino acid sequence. So for this, again, he was awarded Nobel Prize during 1958. This is with respect to discovery of insulin. Coming to insulin biosynthesis, we all know that insulin is synthesized from beta cells of islets of Langerhans. Initially, whatever insulin is produced or synthesized in the ribosome, especially in the rough endoplasmic reticulum, it is about 109 amino acids. And this is an inactive insulin. It is called pre-proinsulin. Whatever insulin synthesized from the ribosome, that is protein synthesis or translation, it is an inactive insulin. It is made up of 109 amino acid, and the whole peptide or protein chain is only one chain. Again, some amino acids are cleaved off during the process in Golgi apparatus. Some amino acids are cleaved off by proteolytic cleavage. It is called proinsulin. Still, it is one chain. And it is made up of around 86 amino acids. Pre-proinsulin, around 109 amino acids. Some ladder sequence is cleaved off by proteolytic enzyme. Now we have 86 amino acids. This one peptide chain is called proinsulin. Still, it is an inactive insulin or precursor of insulin. Just before the release to the circulation, again, some amino acids, around 31 to 34 amino acids, are cleaved off. That is our 51 amino acids active insulin. While doing so, while converting proinsulin to insulin, there are some amino acids are cleaved off. These amino acids are called C-peptide. So this active insulin is made up of two chains. This is exactly proinsulin. As I mentioned, it is made up of 86 amino acids. 86 amino acids. You can see all proteins or peptides start one side, it will be amino terminal end. Another side, it will be carboxy terminal end or C terminal end. This is a one chain. It is made up of 86 amino acids. Remember, this is a proinsulin, which is synthesized from pre-proinsulin. Now, during the process, some amino acids are cleaved off. This particular region is cleaved off. This entire region is called C-peptide. During formation of active insulin, this particular amino acid chain, around 31 to 34 amino acids are cleaved off. This is called C-peptide. And now we have two chains, and this will become A chain, this will become B chain. So here there will be N terminal end, here there will be C terminal end, and this B chain, here there will be COOH. Proinsulin converted to active insulin, that must be some amino acid sequence should be cleaved off by proteolytic cleavage. Whatever amino acids are cleaved off, they are called C-peptide. This does not have any metabolic role, but for significance of measurement of amount of insulin released from the pancreas, we can measure this C-peptide because it remains in the circulation for some time when compared to insulin. The half-life of C-peptide is more when compared to the insulin half-life. Now we will study the exact structure of active insulin. Okay, our insulin looks like, so this is our A chain, this is our B chain. So now A chain contains 21 amino acids, whereas B chain contains 30 amino acids. And remember, these chains are interconnected. They are interconnected by strong covalent bond called disulfide bond. So they are interconnected by two strong disulfide bond. We know that disulfide bond is formed by amino acid cysteine. We have cysteine in the A chain, 7th amino acid is cysteine, and in the B chain also 7th amino acid is cysteine. Whenever cysteine is there, they contain sulfhydryl group. Whenever in any protein or peptide, if two cysteine amino acids are there, they will form a disulfide bond. This is a strong covalent bond along with the peptide bond. Similarly, the 20th amino acid of A chain is also cysteine, and 19th amino acid of B chain is also cysteine. Again, there will be one more disulfide bond. The two chains, A chains and B chains, are interconnected by a strong disulfide bond. In addition to this two inter-disulfide bond, A chain has got one more intra-disulfide bond. Intra means within. The 6th amino acid of A chain is also cysteine, and the 11th amino acid of A chain is also cysteine amino acid. So there will be one more disulfide bond. This bond is within the A chain itself. This is called intrachain disulfide bond, whereas these two are interchain disulfide bond. Okay, this is the structure of insulin. Apart from this, the first amino acid of A chain is glycine. This will be glycine. And the last amino acid of A chain is aspargine. Similarly, B chain contains, the first amino acid is always phenylalanine, and the last amino acid is threonine. You need to remember this insulin, whether you take from bovine or pig or horse or sheep, the majority of amino acid sequence are same. Only minor change. That means insulin is a hormone which has got very less species variation. If you take bovine and pig insulin structure is almost similar to human insulin, even bovine insulin. Okay? If you take pig insulin and bovine insulin, the 30th amino acid is alanine instead of threonine. So this will be the 30th amino acid will be alanine in case of bovine as well as pig. Total we have, A chain has got 21 amino acids and B chain has got 30 amino acids. So together we have 51 amino acids. Among this entire 51 amino acid, the species variation there in amino acid 8, amino acid 9 and amino acid 10. So in human and pig, the amino acid sequence in 8th, 9th and 10th is threonine, 9th amino acid is serine, and the 10th amino acid is isoleucine. So this 8th amino acid is threonine, serine and isoleucine. This is in human as well as in pig. This is the species variation. If you take bovine, the 8th amino acid will be alanine, and the 9th amino acid is same, serine, and the 10th amino acid is valine. This is in case of bovine. If you take sheep, the 8th amino acid will be alanine, and the 9th amino acid will be glycine, and the 10th amino acid will be valine. If you take horse, the 8th amino acid will be threonine, and the 9th amino acid will be glycine, and the 10th amino acid will be isoleucine. You can see very, very minor variation, that is species variation. You can see bovine and pig insulin is, the structure is very close to human insulin. The first amino acid in A chain and B chain are similar in all species, even the last amino acid in the A chain. This is the structure of insulin. Insulin contains A chain and B chain. They are connected by a strong covalent bond called disulfide bond between 7th amino acid of A chain and 7th amino acid of B chain, and 20th amino acid of A chain and 19th amino acid of B chain. And in addition to this, A chain also has got an intrachain disulfide bond. This is about the structure of insulin. Thanks for watching.